look what Jesus said. For he, the Holy Spirit, shall receive a man. And so everything we're going to ever get, if the only way we can be in peace to not have our hearts be troubled is we got to receive from Jesus, from the Holy Spirit. He shall receive a man. Look. Everything, this peace and all this, it ain't never ours. We get to enjoy it. It's all the Lord's. He shall receive a man, and guess what? And show it on us. Look at the attitude and the faith and the believing that's required to walk in this. Is Jesus got it all? So there has to be a constant trusting, believing, thinking about him, who he is and what he did and what he accomplished, so that we are always looking to what he has accomplished to see that work in our lives. You see? Do you see that? Am I making that clear? Now look at 15 is the bomb. All things. Everybody say all things.
All things.
That the Father had on that. You never notice he never said they're all yours. You want me to tell you why? Because they ain't. Because if they ever became yours and mine, we mess it up. We have to be partakers of this. God didn't try and get it to Adam. He already found out what we'll do. So all things that the Father had for man. Come on, you mess it up. You get mad. Take our power and hit somebody upside the head because they didn't act right. Jesus had to come down the cross to show us how to do when we suffer. We kill people, we had all God power. We wouldn't take anything from people.
No. Jesus, brother.
You know you're Jesus. All things that the Father had a man. And look, therefore said I. And look what Jesus said. He shall take of man and show it unto you. So every day in every life situations, the Holy Spirit's got to take what was the victory and the peace that was in Jesus and show us that peace in our life, in every situation. Got to show it to you. And you've got to be looking for it. Now go to Ephesians 2 now. Get down to the nitty gritty now. I had to do all that just to get y'all right here. Ephesians 2:12. Now listen carefully, because the anointing's finna explode in here. It's gonna explode. Can I quote you one verse while I read this? In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14, the Bible says, follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Guess what God wants you to follow every day? Peace. Really, he wants you to follow him giving you something. Him doing something for you every day. He wants you to follow him doing something for you every day with all men. And then holiness is Jesus being able to tell you and separate you from how the world is and tell you his way of living. Holiness is Jesus telling you his way of living.
Yes.
Which sets you apart. He said, without which no man shall see the Lord. In the Greek, y'all, Rick Renner is a Greek scholar. He's over in Russia. And Rick taught this the definition of some of these words. And what he taught was that in the Greek, that you won't see the Lord now. Right down there. See, I always see the Lord now. I will never see the Lord later on in no problem. And when you're not following Jesus giving you all the time, and Jesus telling you his way of living, you be struggling with problems and you don't see the Lord right now. You don't see him right now, man. You mean, see him later, maybe. But you don't see him right now. You don't see him right now. But you could see him right now. I done seen him right now, every day, every situation, over 20-some years. I'm following peace. Jesus tell me, forgive him, forget it. Jesus always giving me. Well, you know I forgave you. Yes, sir. Never fighting him. Not day have I ever fought the Lord. Not in one situation, not one have I fought the Lord. I didn't understand some things three times in the first 5 years, I'll say, but I straightened it up about 10 minutes, 15 minutes at most. I never fought the Lord. I never argued with him. Oh God, I'm just mad. I ain't never been like that my whole Christian walk. The sad people running that stinking confidence to God. They think it's okay. And they struggle too. Because they don't see the Lord right now. Because they're not following peace. And they are not living holy. Yes. And you don't see the Lord right now. That's not going to mean you ain't born again. You don't see the Lord. You go through troubles. Financial trouble. All kind of troubles. This trouble. Your family trouble. Your kid trouble. I got people in my family. I go to sleep every night. I say, Lord, you have saved me. I know you can do something with him. I'm going to sleep. Yeah. I can't tell me Father what's wrong with everybody. I don't do it in church. I said, I lay in bed. I said, Lord, you know so-and-so called today, and so-and-so called today, and so-and-so, and they said this wrong, and so-and-so, they ain't got their rent. And if you don't tell me, I'm not going to pay a damn well because they ain't doing right. But if you tell me, I'll give them mercy. And I said, Lord, these are yours. And I said, Lord, this is what I'm saying. All right. I never work out problems for nobody. I never use my mind to let it figure out nothing. I done learned to let the Lord speak to me and show me what to do, because I am trusting that he knows everything and I don't. And that's how I stay in peace every day. I never work out nothing. And I be in peace and don't even know how nothing gonna turn out. But I know Jesus know. I don't even have to know. All I know and believe that he gonna do it. And I'm all right. Now at that time you were without Christ. Listen, you don't never want to live that no more. Were you without Christ. So you always want to be with Christ. And being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God. You don't never want to be in a situation where you are without God and without some hope and sitting there struggling and sitting there worrying and sitting there stressing when you got this great big God and you're acting like you're in the world with no hope. It's pitiful. It's pitiful. They've been going to church all their life walk like this. They're all right because something go wrong. They're all right something go wrong. Look at verse 13. But now in Christ Jesus, you who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Jesus. Look what brought you in this. Jesus giving you his blood. And that's what he's got to keep doing. He's got to keep his blood, you all, is your peace. Verse 14. For he is our peace. If you don't remember the blood every day and you don't worship him for the blood, this is how you keep his peace, because he loved you with his blood when you didn't deserve it. And that's supposed to always bring you in remembrance that he will come through you again and for you again and again, because he came through for you with his blood when you never had nothing to do with
it. Hallelujah.
So he's never holding no blessing back from none of us. Even if you screwed up, he done forgave that screwed up sin so he can still bless you if you will let him. He's at peace. He made both one and it broken down the middle wall of partition between us. Go to Hebrews 9:14. And then I got one more scripture. We'll close. But I'm not going to be in no hurry. I got something from God. If people don't want this, man, I'll go where the Lord tells me to go. But I got an audience. You understand? I'm on TV every day. You understand? I got an audience. I got Burks and them and some of y'all. I mean, I got an audience. Because you can't teach this to people nowhere that ain't hungry for it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They just go in one ear and come out the other if you ain't hungry for this.
Right.
Hungry for Jesus.
Yes, sir.
And don't none of us ain't arrived.
No.
But I'm going to tell y'all something I have arrived in. I have arrived in knowing who got all the answers. I'm perfect in that area. I never miss it in that. I never miss going to Jesus. I never miss that. I got that perfect. I am mature as I can ever be in that. I can't grow no more in that. I can't grow no more in that. I run to him about everything. I tell the Lord, he pastors my church. I said, Lord, this is your church. I tell the saints, look. Y'all don't tithe and give. I ain't finna be hurt. We won't shut down because everything paid for.
Hallelujah.
I said, if two snaggers, two women come down here with bald heads, I'll just preach to them. I don't run the church to get money from people. I don't come here. I told the Lord, purpose my heart, why I come to bless your people, not to come and get a dad. But then I get to pray that. I said, oh, Lord, I'm trusting you for this or not. But I never mix them. Now, I never mix them. You wouldn't know what that was in my heart for years if that was that.
Yes,
I come to bless his people.
Amen.
I done kept that all these years. Well, God has to bless me because I can't do it. I don't even do it on TV. I don't promise them nothing. I said, look, y'all, I ain't gonna promise y'all nothing. I said, look, you either love this message and enjoy God giving you some revelation and send me some money to help me, or you keep your money, I'll keep on teaching you for nothing.
Thank you.
And so all my dependency ain't never on people. All my dependency is all on the Lord. If God don't keep me on TV, I ain't gonna stay on. And I'd rather go off anyway, to be honest with you. So much work. I told the Lord when he asked me to go on TV, I said, Lord, once we get somebody, if they don't tell me to preach, we'd like to go on. I don't want to go on. I know how much work and money that's gonna be. And so every time the town go in, it's about empty now. The way it is. I think $1,005 in there. I got to go back and put a bunch in there. And I told the Lord, I said, Lord, this I am with Jesus. What's about my faith? Lord, your account's empty.
All right.
Your account. What I told. Lord, have you noticed this? We down to $1,000, you know, because we believe God. At the first of the year, we put about almost $30,000 in there. We'll spend all that gone. Gone. We can't even pay nothing this month without the Lord. And I just love to get in these spots. I love to get in these spots because I know I'm going to see his love come through for me. So I embrace when he goes through this. I count it all joy that my God will not fail me what he told me to do. So I get excited, man, that the camp get low. He said, be a good cheer. I done got happy now, y'all. Look at this verse. This verse right here is a knockout. How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal spirit offered himself without spot to God, look, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God. This is the problem with the majority of people in the body of Christ. Father, I'm sitting up. Their conscience has never been cleansed by the blood of Jesus from dead works. They still believe they got to love God and do something for God to get God to love you. And you never did nothing for the blood. You never did nothing for the blood. You ain't love him. You ain't love your neighbors yourself. You ain't keep no commandments. You didn't do nothing to get that blood to cleanse you and forgive you. And so he wants the blood to put you in a place where he's in love with you. Which will cause you to end up loving him and doing what he tell you to do. If you let him love you. There's no way you can't love somebody do anything for you. It's impossible. And people got dead works. You know what dead works is? Anything you have something to do with. Anything, look at your neighbor and say, anything you have something to do with it, dead. But see what the blood did, that will make you serve the living God. If it can get in there and get that work mentality out of you, that trying to do something to get God to bless. Lord, I gave my tithes. Will you bless me? Will you bless me? He already done blessed you in Jesus. Giving your tithes is living his love to others so you can continue to walk in the blessing. But he blessed you before you ever gave a damn. You didn't give no money, no tithe to get the blood. The blood. And this the blood is supposed to cleanse your conscience from you doing anything to get God to love you. The blood is supposed to knock out your dead works. And let me tell you, you're supposed to have only one work. In John 6:29. Jesus said, this is the work of God, that you believe on him who God has sent. That's the only work Christians supposed to have. The rest of them are dead. And people ain't got their conscience cleansed, that they ain't got to earn God's love. Well, I didn't do it wrong. He still loves you. We've been missing it. Hey, the blood's forgave you. Go receive that forgiveness. Amen. Let the blood put you on the trail with Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He has to purge your conscience from dead works so you can serve the living God. You can't serve him and you're in dead works. You have to serve him through the blood and how he loved you. Let's close in Hebrews chapter 10 verse 19. I need four verses here, so follow me now. I'm going down to verse 23. I need four verses. Now y'all listening to this. This is what I'm going to teach y'all. Right here will change your life forever. Please get this CD and last night. This will change your life forever. It'll enhance what you already have. Having that for a brother in boldness. How many of y'all got a margin in your Bible? Yeah, how many of y'all got a margin right down the middle? And if you look the word Greek up right there, by verse 19, it should say liberty. My Bible say liberty. We have liberty to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. We have liberty to do that. You got to know that God is not requiring you to live right to get to him. It's through the blood of your faith in the blood of Jesus that you can get to God. Even if you got something wrong, the blood can still get you to God.
Jesus.
To get him to do something about it. To get him to do something about your trouble. The blood still can get you in because the blood cleansed you while you was yet a sinner. It did not cleanse you when you got right. And so you got to know that you are not going to God because you're doing everything right. You're going to God because Jesus did everything right. And he'll straighten it up if it ain't right. Get in there with God and find out. And people, they don't get in there with God when something's wrong, when troubles come and fears come. Because they got dead works. They're trying to earn this. They think how they done did can affect Jesus. No, how Jesus did can affect you. Look at verse 20. Oh, it gets better, y'all. By a new and living way which he has consecrated for us. Look, you see, GM knows right there. You didn't consecrate this for us. He consecrated this for us through the veil. That is to say, his flesh. Come on, give me some more verses. And having a high priest over the house of God. Come on, give me another one. Let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of, look, what are you going to come? With a full heart of assurance. What is your full assurance of Jesus? You're supposed to have full assurance that Jesus came from God. He knows everything, and he's done one this thing. You're supposed to come with full assurance of Jesus and his blood. Watch. Having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience that something we've done wrong can stop the blood from getting us to God. Man, we're supposed to be cleansed from that mess. We're supposed to be prosperous and blessed every day. Christians, get this, you'll quit being broke. You'll quit living paycheck to paycheck. And our bodies washed with pure water. Now I'm going to close in verse 23. I could teach on this a whole lot more. Let me tell you what they did in the Greek. You got King James? Look at the King James down there. And look at that. Let us hold fast the profession of our. Will you tell me, is that word our with italicized or is it in the original Greek? It's italicized. Let's take that out. Let us hold fast the confession of faith without wavering. Who is he talking about? Jesus. Let us hold fast the confession of who Jesus is without wavering who he is. Well, for he is faithful that promised. He's talking about Jesus. He ain't talking about us trying to hold fast to say something without faith. He's saying, hold fast to say something about Jesus. Don't waver who Jesus is. Oh, man. Because he is faithful. And probably he's talking about us. I done heard them preaching for years. Now y'all hold fast to your faith. Now y'all hold fast to your faith. Now y'all hold fast. It's all about holding fast to Jesus. Because they said he is faithful. They promised what? Untroubled. My peace I give you. Not as the world give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. I'll show you how to make this work. I'll show you how to turn things around. I'll show you how to be blessed on every side. I'll teach you how to be more than a conqueror. See, you're just trying to say that every day. We're more than conquerors through him who loved us. We're more saints than just whooping something. We get to tell stuff. You can't work in my life no more. I'll never be broke another day in my life. I'll never live in lack no more the rest of my life because of Jesus. Because Jesus is turning it around for me. I'm healed by Jesus' stripes. I've been delivered from the power of darkness, transferred into the kingdom of his dear son, in whom I have redemption through the blood of Jesus, even the forgiveness of my sins. I've been delivered. I'm made a partaker of the inheritance of the saints in light. God has delivered me from the control and the dominion of darkness. He has put me into the son he loved, whom I have redemption through his blood. I can get to Jesus. I can take communion when something ain't right so it'll get right. I do not have to be perfect to come and take communion. Communion is supposed to get me right. Sometimes when I've been in stuff, the Lord said, go take communion. He didn't tell me, wait till I got it right and take it. I took it and got right. I remember him and what he did for me. It helped me get right.
All right. That's good.
He's trying to help us. He ain't working against nobody. People working against themselves and working with the devil. Stand to your feet. Hallelujah. He's faithful that promised y'all. Jesus is faithful that promised. He's faithful that promised. Let me tell y'all, I got a few minutes. I got to finish something I started last night. And the Lord reminded me, I didn't get it correct last night. I got to do it tonight. Let me tell you what Jesus told me. I was preaching at church. I was in prayer. Jesus said, go back and teach the saints how I taught you when you first started. Get them to do what I taught you, and it'll work for them the same way. We ever saw people get $30,000 raises, all kind of doors opening up, all kind of deliverances, healings, miracles in their lives personally by doing what I'm going to tell y'all tonight. Now, y'all that came down last night, you need to come back again, because I want. And if you want to go up, come down here and just stand all around the altar. I'm going to show y'all how to do it. Come on. It's not hard. Oh, God, ain't you glad it ain't hard? This is how the Lord told me to do it, y'all. You know what I mean? Wait, I got to obey. And here's what Jesus told me. Come on down. Because I want to come back and y'all done exploded in this. And I know many of y'all walk with the Lord, so don't. You know, this is encouraging to me to continue this. Now listen, here's what Jesus told me. This is what I did when I first got saved. I surrendered my life to Jesus Christ to serve Him and follow Him and to do God's will. I totally committed myself to never follow the devil another day in my life. And I haven't in 23 years. I've never followed the devil. And he done tricked me in a bunch of stuff. And when Jesus showed me, I never did go back into trick no more. You understand? I couldn't help it. I was deceived in something. But once the light came, turned out, I didn't walk in that no more. That's the best I can live. But what I did perfect is I spend time with the Lord every day to listen to the Holy Spirit so Jesus could tell me what to do. I've done it every day and still do. Now here's what Jesus told me. He said He wants you to yield yourself to the Holy Spirit every day. And He wants you to yield in a way where you are looking for Him to tell you what to do. And you have to do it. Some of y'all, he done got cold talking to you. And it's not that He's not there. You are not pursuing Him right like you used to. And let me tell you what I missed last night that I got to tell you tonight. And here's what Jesus told me. He told me this last night. He said, come back and go tell him again. And then add this in there because I didn't remember it. He said that when you obey what the Holy Spirit tell you, He said it'll bleed over into areas that you need Him to work in. If you will yield yourself to Him every day to do what the Spirit tell you to do, it'll bleed over into the areas that you're struggling or need help in. He'll just come and help you in areas that you really wasn't even praying about. How many of y'all have seen Him do that before? And that comes from you yielding to obey what the Holy Spirit tell you to do. He's going to tell some of y'all get up in the morning and pray a little bit more. He's going to tell you something. He'll tell you to call somebody, tell them you're sorry. He'll tell you to go to work and get something straightened out with people where you can get in peace. He's going to tell you to stop doing something, looking at something on TV you ain't got no business looking at. He's going to tell you something. And when He tell you, if you don't obey it, you can't walk in this. You just can't do it. You have to keep struggling and keep troubles. So every day, I want y'all to lift your hands up. We'll start tonight. He might tell you to run around and shoot chairs. He might tell you to jump up and down. He might tell you to praise Him. I don't know what He's going to tell you. But whatever He tell you to do, if He tell you something tonight, you do it. So say out loud, say, Father,
Father,
I thank you
for sending us Jesus.
We yield
to the Spirit of truth.
Who will glorify Jesus.
He will take what belongs to Jesus
and show it to us.
I yield to you, Holy Spirit.
I repent
of every wrong thought,
every wrong word,
every wrong deed,
every wrong thing spoken from my tongue.
wash me in your blood, Lord Jesus, and cleanse me from all unbelief, all dead works, all of my ability that are trying to have something to do with this. I yield to you, Holy Spirit. Whatever you tell me, I will do it. In Jesus' name, now shout about that.
Increase.
greatness of God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Well, y'all, let's go ahead and receive an offering for my ministry. Make your checks to Northside. But all of this will go to help me. And Jesus is the answer. Every penny will go to help me in the ministry. So y'all bow your heads. Father, thank you. Lord, I'm believing you. Amen. One more time. And I thank you for a real good offering tonight, Lord, to help me. Amen. We'll go back and do everything we need to do. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord, for prospering your people. And Lord, just increasing them in the revelation of your love. That's your grace, the revelation of your love. And I thank you for that, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. So be generous tonight. Amen. Be generous. Amen. You sow bountifully, you reap bountifully. You sow sparingly, you reap sparingly. So y'all help me. Amen. And I know the Lord will never forget. God is raising me up, saints, to teach this message around the world. Amen. Don't look up. You see me. I'm going on nationwide on TV here real soon. They've been trying to get me on Dish. One of them things, but it's all over the United States. So it's coming.
Thank you, Jesus.
I gotta teach this. I gotta teach this to people. Some of the grace messages are wrong. They're teaching people, 1 John 1 is not from God. It's for sinners. I said, no, that's for Christians. And so they really, man, got grace messed up. And I got to come behind them and teach the truth to straighten it out, balance it. Amen. And the faith message, and the prosperity message. Balance. All of them need some balance. Man, they need some balance. Got to need, sow a seed. That's ridiculous. How about got to need, show some love? And then your faith will work if you live in Jesus' love.
Yes.
See, a lot of stuff people give it, it's really love and it's working, but the way it's taught is wrong. Because God do bless our giving.
Yes.
But what he really blesses is us living in love.
Yes.
I'm telling y'all, let me give y'all scriptures. Judge not, you will not be judged. Condemn not, you'll not be condemned. Forgive, and you'll be forgiven. Give, and it'll be given. He ain't talking about no money. He talking about the way you live in love is when people gonna bless you all the time.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, man. Then he said, put up there, 1 Peter 3, verse 9. New Living Translation. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 9. Listen to this. In the New Living Translation, it's living Jesus' love in your giving that's going to keep you prosperous, saints. They just done took money, man, and made that because they can. They did it in the Old Testament. But money in Christ is to give, to live his love, and to honor Jesus. And then God blesses you for living his love. That's our commandment. It's to love one another as he loved us. We should not do nothing that ain't out of love. Nothing. Tithes or offerings. No way the Lord can tell us to do something out of law. He tells us to do everything out of love. Not rendering evil for evil, ready for ready, but contrary blessing, knowing that you are thereunto called. That you will inherit a blessing from God. When you don't pay people back, God said, I'm going to inherit and call you to a blessing.
Hallelujah.
That's how you live blessed, keeping your tongue from evil and your lips from guile. Your giving is to love people, love the church, love the ministry, love the gospel, seeing people's lives change, taking care of the church and the ministry. But the way we walk in love is our blessings.
Yes, yes.
Oh.
Thank you.
Hold on, Doc, we gotta finish that.
already. Why don't you come on down, Doc, and let them come on down here tonight. I'm going to pray over it. Amen. Y'all lift it up. Stand up and lift it up to heaven. I just want the Lord to bless this. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, thank you for your people, for their love. I pray, Lord, as you've promised in your word in Hebrews 16, that you are not unrighteous to forget our labor of love that we show toward your name and toward the saints. And you will not forget their labor of love. And Lord, that you will increase them so they can be a greater blessing to the kingdom and to your work. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Come on down. Because God's going to increase you.